JFT, just fair and direct.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to JFD's daily market review for March the 3rd. I am Charalambos, Pissouros, senior market analyst here at JFD, and I will talk about yesterday's main market movers, what's my opinion moving ahead, what are today's important events, and how they could affect the markets. But before we start, let's read our disclaimer. The content we produce does not constitute investment advice or investment recommendation, should not be considered as such, and does not in any way constitute an invitation to acquire any financial instrument or product. I will leave you a few seconds to read the rest, and then we will jump into our analysis. Okay, the US dollar traded lower against all but two of the other G10 currencies on Tuesday and during the Asian session Wednesday. It lost the most ground versus NOK, SEK and Aussie, while it was found virtually unchanged against CHF and JPY. The relative weakness in the safe havens yen and franc, combined with the strengthening of the risk-linked Aussie, suggests that markets turn to risk on again at some point. Indeed, although EU indices were mixed and the US ones slid, the Asian ones traded higher, with Japan's Nikkei 225 and China Shanghai in composite gaining 0.51 and 1.95% respectively. Wall Street finished its trading session lower, driven by losses in technology stocks, perhaps as investors moved out of stocks that outperformed due to the coronavirus pandemic into others viewed as likely to do well as the economy recovers. What's more, they may have adopted a cautious stance ahead of the debate in Senate over President Biden's $1.9 trillion stimulus package. In any case, market sentiment improved during the Asian session as government bond yields pulled back. Lately, the surge in government bond yields was the result of fears of higher inflation as the global economy recovers from the damages of the pandemic, which could lead major central banks to start normalizing their respective policies. This forced equities to retreat. However, with several officials noting that any spike in inflation this year is likely to prove to be temporary and that they are planning to keep their policies extra loose, we don't expect equities to continue falling for long. We will treat the latest setback as a corrective phase. We stick to our guns that equities are likely to rebound and trend north again as investors digest the idea that any spike in inflation will prove to be temporary. In the currency world, this could mean a weaker dollar as well as weaker safe havens like the yen and the franc. On the other hand, risk-linked currencies the like of Aussie and Kiwi are likely to strengthen. Now, as for today's events, we have the final services and composite PMIs for February from Eurozone, the UK and the US, as well as the US's ISM non-manufacturing index for the month, which is anticipated to have held steady at 58.7. The ADP employment report for February is also coming out, and it is expected to show that the private sector has gained 168,000 jobs, less than the 174,000 jobs added in January. This is likely to raise speculation that the NFPs due out on Friday may come near their own forecast of 165,000. Now, on the political front, in the UK, Finance Minister Rishi Sunak will present the nation's budget and he is expected to pledge on more spending. However, this may be the last pandemic-related aid he offers. In any case, a generous package may allow the pound to trade higher. Apart from the UK Finance Minister Rishi Sunak, we have eight more speakers on today's agenda, and those are ECB Vice President Luis de Guindos, ECB Governing Council Member Jens Weidmann, ECB Executive Board Member Fabio Panetta, ECB Executive Board Member Isabel Schnabel, Bank of England Monetary Policy Committee Member Silvana Denreiro, Atlanta Fed President Rafael Bostic, Chicago Fed President Charles Evans, and RBNZ Governor Adrian Orr. So that's it from me. Thank you very much for watching and listening. For those who are interested in learning about the main events of the week much earlier, you can subscribe to the weekly Market Outlook webinar, which I'm hosting every Monday at 8 o'clock AM GMT. You can find the link in the description below. So goodbye, have a great day, and I'm looking forward to seeing you here again tomorrow.
JFT, just fair and direct.